Hello friends, in this video we are going to prove another theorem, that is, all the bases of a vector space including the standard bases have same number of vectors. Or you can say, like, suppose the vector set u1, u2 up to um and the vector set v1, v2 up to vn forms two bases, two different bases. Means this vector set forms one basis, this vector set forms another basis of the same vector space V, then we will say that the number of vectors in each of these set are equal, m equals to n. So now we are going to prove this theorem. So given is B1 is first base which contains the vectors u1, u2, u3 up to um. So number of vectors in the basis B1 is m. Second basis contains the vectors v1, v2, v3 up to vn. So number of vectors in the basis 2 is n. So these are the two bases of vector space V. Then the elements of B2 can be spanned by that of B1 and vice versa. So then elements of basis 2 can be spanned by that of B1 and vice versa, because the vectors which are present in the basis 2 also belongs to the vector space V. And since B1 is the basis of vector space V, so the vector V1 which belongs to vector space V can be spanned as a linear combination of these vectors which belongs to set B1. So this is what we have written here. Now we are going to prove this theorem using contradiction method. So let m is not equals to n, and we are taking if m is less than n, then now I am going to express the elements of B2 as a linear combination of elements of B1. So vector V1 can be expressed as alpha 1 and 1, that is U1, plus alpha 1. This 1 represents the index of this vector V1, and this represents the index of this. So alpha 1 to U2, and likewise alpha 1 index of this, and the total number of vectors in B1 is m. So this is m um. So likewise we have to express all these vectors which belongs to B2 as a linear combination of B1. So alpha 2 1 u1, alpha 2 2 u2, and so on, alpha 2 m um. So likewise we have to express all these n vectors of B2 as the linear combination of B1 vectors. So alpha n 2 u2, so on, plus alpha n m u m, like this. So now I can write this whole thing in the form of matrix. So this is V U A. So V is the column matrix which represents these vectors V1, V2 up to Vn. U is the column matrix which represents these U1, U2 up to Um. And A is the coefficient matrix which represents all alpha. So I can write it as V1, V2 up to Vn, all these vectors. Now U can be expressed as a column matrix which contains all these vectors U1, U2 up to Um. And A can be expressed as alpha 1 1 alpha 1 2, likewise alpha 1 m. So these all coefficients we have written in first row. So when this column will multiply this with this first row, we will get this equation. So v1 is equals to alpha 1 1 u1, alpha 1 2 u2, like this we will get this equation. So likewise this is alpha 2 1 alpha 2 2 up to alpha 2 m, likewise we will proceed further. So this is alpha m alpha it should be 1 second. Okay, so it is n alpha n 2, like this is alpha n m. Now this can be written as v equals to u a, and where a is equals to alpha I j m cross n. Now consider the homogeneous system. Consider the homogeneous system, that is a x bar equals to 0, and here since m is less than n, the system ax is equals to 0 has non-trivial solution. So it means there exists x bar which is not equals to 0, so that ax is equals to 0. So this is the homogeneous system which we have considered, and since m is less than n, and here this x bar is the column matrix which contains x unknowns, and we have m number of equations, so number of equations is less than number of unknowns, so the system has non-trivial solution. So it means there exists x bar where all the scalars, all the unknowns are not equals to 0, so that this homogeneous system holds true. So ax equals to 0, this has non-trivial solution. Now if I multiply this equation by u on both sides, then this side will be 0, so this side will become u a x bar equals to 0, and this u a is equals to v, so this become v x bar equals to 0. And now it means the meaning of this is x1 v1 plus x2 v2, likewise xn vn is equals to 0. And here at least, and we have said that there exists x bar which is not equals to 0, it means all the x, all the coefficient of these x1 x2 cannot be 0 simultaneously. So at least sum x and x I is not equals to 0, because this is the condition. So at least sum x I is not equals to 0, hence, and we know that if these all are not equal to 0, then we cannot say the set of v1, v2 up to vn is linearly independent. So the set of these vectors v1, v2 up to vn is not linearly independent. And if this set is not linearly independent, then this will violate. So this violates this given condition that the set of v1, v2, v3 up to vn forms the basis of the given vector space V. So it means this contradicts our supposition, or you can say our assumption, it contradicts our assumption. Which assumption? That B2 is basis. V2 is basis of V. So this contradicts our assumption that B2 is basis of V. It means M is not less than N. So M is equals to N. Here only we cannot say that M is equals to N. It may be the case that M is greater than N. So this is the first condition that we have taken, that is M is less than N. So similarly we will prove for N is greater than M, or sorry, that is N is less than M. So when we prove this, similarly we will prove this. So this is contradicted, so similar way this will also get contradicted. So whatever is left is true, so we will left with M is equals to N. So that has to be equal, so M is equals to N we will get in final step. So this is how we prove this theorem. So so basically this theorem says that if a vector space V has any number of bases, because it can have any number of bases, so the number of vectors which are present in each basis, so the number of vectors should be equal, and it must be equal, it will be equal. So this is the meaning of this theorem. I hope you understand this concept in depth. Thank you.